The burial of late Elder Morgan Victor Ogiri attracted people from all walks of life who came to accord Elder Morgan the last respect for a fulfilled life he lived. At the open-air service held at Ogoda Community, it was testimony of his hard work, humility and kindness to people who came across him.
We have missed him so much. We have missed his advice. We have missed all that he stood for. We believed in him and will continue to celebrate him.
Pastor Professor Inwoma said late Elder Morgan Ogiri lived an exemplary Christian life, was upright with all his dealings with anyone who came in contact with him. He called on the bereaved family to take solace in the Lord.
The Bible says his works do follow him. When he embraced the grace of God, as we learned in his testimony, he gave all full commitments and dedication to the cause of God. He never turned back. His dedication and faithfulness and devotion to God were not in doubt. Morgan Ogiri
was a patron
of goodwill and development
in Ekpaya Land. He worked for the interests of Ekpaya Land.
He was an advocate of peace and progress. He and his wife demonstrated this by raising their children in godly path and equipping them to be useful to themselves and to society.
Special song were rendered by Ekpaya Zonal Choir in honor of late Morgan. Late Elder Morgan Ogiri was described as epitome of humility and simplicity, and ardent believers of God's words, as testified by children, friends, and relatives.
My dad, when you think of love, you think of my dad. That is his key word. My dad is a very kind man. He's very loving to his children and everyone he meets. He does not discriminate. Whether you're his child or not, he loves you anyway. He takes care of you. My dad knows no stranger. Anyone he sees outside, his first thought is to take care of the person, to feed them, to clothe them. My dad is there for the orphans, for the widows. My dad is there for his children. He's our protector, our provider. He's our role model and our hero.
Well, the message, like I said yesterday, my father is a peace-loving person, and if you come into his house, he doesn't care who you are. He doesn't want to know who you are. You must be fed. You must drink. So my message from Aspa, the daughter of the disease, is that we should love one another. No barriers. No matter who you are, whether you are up there or down there, we are one. Christ has made us one, and Christ has said we are all equal. So we should love one another. It doesn't matter who the person is.
His piece of advice, he always brings me to order. Always, always. He doesn't mind when I'm upset. He doesn't mind whatever. When I've gone astray, he called me and say, hey, don't do it this way. You do it this way, you're gonna go wrong. You do it this way, you're gonna go right. I crack joke with him. I miss his joke. I miss his joke. But of it all, he guides me.
Kingdom and the Ekpaya nationality had lost a gentleman to the core whose experience and knowledge is only to maintain peace and order. He's a peaceful person.
Morgan was an excellent man, was a father to all. In fact, the tributes that were said here was typical of who he was, and we miss him greatly.
Late Elder Morgan Ogiri was born on the 29 September 1942 to the family of late Victor Ogiri of Umuchi family, all of Ogoda community in Awoda West local government area. He was a core and conservative Sabbath keeper who made sacrifice to keep the Sabbath day holy. He left behind his wife, 6 daughters and 1 son. The remains of late Morgan Ogiri was lowered in his compound. From Ogoda, in Awuda West local government area of River State, Dianukume Ulolu, NTA News.